Hello friends, welcome to our channel Knowledge Amplifier. So in my previous video I have shown you the detailed derivation of multiple linear regression using matrix calculus and somewhat use of linear algebra also, right? So in my this particular video I am going to discuss one very important concept which is frequently asked in the machine learning or data science related interview process, and that is proof that the sum of all the errors, okay, which we get in multiple linear regression model is equal to zero, okay, right? So that's what I am going to prove, okay? So in my previous video, what we have done, we have created set of linear equations from the training data what we had, and then we have converted that to its matrix form, and this particular error column, right, we have taken this particular column multiplied by its transpose, which is basically giving us the dot product. That means that is nothing but what? That is nothing but sum of all the individual terms square, okay? That is nothing but summation over I equal to 1 to n error square, which is basically epsilon transpose multiplied by epsilon, where epsilon is suppose this particular error column, okay? That one we have minimized, and when we have tried to minimize, we have got the regression coefficient we should get from this particular equation W equal to x transpose x whole inverse multiplied by x transpose into y, okay, where what is x? X is basically this particular matrix, right, this one, and y is basically my output feature, output values, okay, right? So now see this particular one equation, okay, what we have done here we are basically taking first derivative with respect to regression coefficient to minimize the sum of square of the error terms, and what we have achieved, this particular equation, right? Then what we have done, as you know from the fundamental concept of calculus, that if either minima or maxima is appearing that time, their first derivative should be zero. So we have put first derivative equal to zero, and we have proceed to calculate the value of W. Now we are going to take this particular equation, that is first derivative equation, that is this one, and here I have written this note, okay? So this same equation I have taken, del del W of epsilon transpose multiplied by epsilon, which is basically nothing but sum of square of all the errors, and that is nothing but this one, right, which should be equal to zero for the optimal values of our regression coefficients, okay? Now here you consider that we have already got our optimal regression coefficient, and I want to prove one very important property, okay, right? So this one, what we had done, equate to zero, right? So take the same equation, that is this one, right? Just what I have done, I have cancelled 2 and multiplied minus 1 in both left and right hand side, and I have got this equation, right? Now what we can do, take x transpose common, and you will be getting this one, okay? Now you tell me, what is x y minus x into w? See this particular equation carefully. This is nothing but my error term, right? Already derived in my previous video. If you go through the detailed derivation, the link I'll be providing in the description box. See here, you can see error equal to y minus x w. So what we can do here, y minus xw we can put as error. So the result what we are getting, x transpose multiplied by the column vector, which is basically our error terms, that is equal to zero. In terms of linear regression, what it indicates, that is nothing but if you have little bit idea about linear algebra, then you can easily understand that these two are orthogonal. What is x? X is one matrix, right? So with respect to matrix, when we tell something orthogonal, that means we will say like this, that this a vector, right, this epsilon is one column vector which is orthogonal to the space which is spanned by the columns of my x, okay? That's what this indicates. Or you can simply tell like this, that error term is orthogonal to x, okay? So x transpose epsilon equal to zero. Right. Now I have to prove this thing, that summation over I equal to 1 to n e of I, that is sum of all the errors, equal to 0. That is, for some values we will be getting positive error, for some training data we will be getting negative error, okay? So all those, when you add up, it also will be nullified and we should get the 0 result, okay? So how we can represent this? See, this is nothing but E1 plus E2 plus so on up to EN. This one we can write like this. One row of error, one cross N matrix, E1, E2, so on up to EN. And one column vector of all ones, 1, 1, 1 like that, N cross 1, right? So this is what? This is nothing but my error matrix epsilon transpose. So I have written here epsilon transpose. And this column matrix I have denoted like this, ones of N cross 1, okay? Right now, see, very carefully try to understand what we will do. We will replace something in this particular one, okay, which is basically one column vector of all ones of n cross one. See what we are going to replace. Very, very important part. Try to understand this one. Our x matrix was this one, right? First column all ones, then x11, x21. This particular column is basically one explanatory variable or our first input feature, then second input feature up to k independent features should be there, which is creating this x matrix. Now with this, we are multiplying one particular column vector, okay? How the column vector is? It is having one as its first element, rest all are zero, and the dimension is k cross one. So this one, my x is n cross k and this is k cross 1. So multiplication possible, just do the multiplication. And what result we can get? See, 1 multiplied by 1, that will be 1 plus x11 multiplied by 0 plus so on x1k multiplied by 0. So the first term will be 1. Like that, if you do the multiplication, you will be getting all the columns as 1 only. And what will be the dimension after multiplication? See, n cross k multiplied by k cross 1, that is nothing but n cross 1. Okay, so basically what we are doing, we are observing that there exists one vector v, that is this vector, where first element is 1 and rest all are 0. When you do x into v, what we are getting? We are getting output as one column vector which is having all the elements as 1 and the dimension is n cross 1. So that's what I have written here. There exists a v. Okay, that V is nothing but this matrix for which we are getting X into V is equal to 1 of N. That means N rows, 1 columns and all the elements are 1. Okay, now this XV we can place in this particular equation. See, step by step we are going. So what we can write? Summation over I equal to 1 to N E of I equal to epsilon transpose into 1 column vector, okay, of n cross 1. Instead of that, I have placed x into v, where x is our that matrix, this one, right? Multiple times I have told you, and v is basically this particular matrix, suppose, okay, one particular matrix v. So we are getting this particular equation. Now group these two. What you will be getting? See, this one can be written like this. Just I have applied the formula AB whole transpose is equal to B transpose A transpose. You can consider X transpose as A, E as B. And then when you are applying whole transpose, you will be getting E transpose multiplied by X transpose transpose, that is X, right? So this is justifiable. Now what is X transpose E? Just now I have told you they are orthogonal, right? So X transpose E is nothing but 0, okay? So 0 transpose multiplied by V. V is 1. Practical vector, column vector, okay, which is fine, is possible in real life, okay, right? This particular vector is possible in real life, right? No problem in that, okay? So 0 transpose multiplied by V, 0 vector, okay, multiplied by any vector, obviously if dimension is satisfied, it is going to give us a big 0, right? So what we are proving? Summation over I equal to 1 to N EI, okay, sum of all the residual is basically 0, okay? Now, you no need to confuse that here we are choosing one particular V, one specific V. You no need to think that it might not be applicable for any other case, okay? Because this is the way how we prove many theorems in linear algebra. One particular condition is sufficient to disagree one particular assumption. One particular thing can sometime validate the whole theorem, right? Here we are just assuming one V, at least one V exists, right? For which at least one V in the whole space exists, for which X into V is nothing but one column vector having all ones, which is our requirement, which we have replaced in this particular one, okay? Nothing mathematically irrelevant we have done, right? And we have got sum of the residual equal to 0. Remember this, sum of the residual if you are applying multiple linear regression, it should be equal to 0. And suppose you have applied any machine learning model and after that you have got sum of residual very big, then that means that your model is not good. You have to do proper steps, okay, either maybe feature scaling or data pre-processing, maybe null value handling or outlier treatment, anything to create the model proper. It is not necessary that sum of residual will be exactly zero, but it should be very small, okay, in general I can say. And this is what is the derivation. I hope you have understood this very simple idea. This is all for this video. Thank you for watching.